Chapel time. What time is it?
Chapel.
What time is it?
Chapel.
Yes. Love the energy today. Good morning. I am Richard. That's right. Good to see you all guys today.
No more Sean the Shepherd.
No more Sean the Shepherd. That is right. Today, we have a new guest, and he's on a, I guess it's a game show. Game show, right? Reality show? I don't know. What reality game show thing, a magic. But we're going to meet him later on, and then we got a new big picture question and a new memory verse. Have you memorized it already? You guys read? You already know it? I think that's a challenge. I think he does know it. It's just in his inner being. Hebrews, do you remember? Hebrews 3, 5 through 6? I don't know. I haven't memorized that either yet. All right. So we've been learning in the book of Genesis. That is right, Asher. Great job. And that is at the end of the Bible? It's before the Bible? At the beginning. That makes sense because Genesis means beginning. The beginning, right? Or beginning. That is right. And we have been learning about Jacob, right? And Jacob, his name turned to Israel. Yeah. So along the way, things have been happening. God's people have been doing bad things. But God has been the what? He's been guiding them. Sometimes people use the word God is the light, right? Because he guides us through. Have you guys heard of that before? Because Jesus is the what? The light of the world, right? So it doesn't matter what we go through. Jesus is our light. He will guide us, right? Yeah. So with that being said, Jesus is the light of the world. Let's stand up and bring our tithes and offerings if we have them. And that's one other way of praising God, to bring your tithes. And we're going to do another way, and that is to worship. So we're going to worship. He is the light. You guys ready? One, two, three, go.
Wherever he will lead me, I'm gonna find breaks through the darkness. Follow his lead and light it up, light it up. Jesus will guide us through every dark time. Follow his lead and light it up, light up the world. Light up the world. Light up the world.
Hi! Hi, everyone! I'm so glad to see all you guys. Hi, I'm Miles. I'm on this
new
game show. It's called The Great Race. Wow. Yeah. Are you guys ready to help me? Because I don't know if I could do it all by myself. I'm so excited. Are you guys excited? Are you? Because I have to go around the world to follow clues to win the great race. Are you guys good with clues? Cool, because I'm clueless. Okay, well, we're going to go ahead and do the first clue. But I'm kind of scared. Are you scared? Oh, okay. Then I'll act like I'm not scared. Okay, so I'm gonna warm up a little bit. Okay, all right. That's good. That feels good. I think I need to go to the hospital. All right, so the first clue. Are you ready? Dun, 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 dun. It says, oh, it's in Spanish. Do you guys know how to read Spanish?
No.
Oh, wait, it's upside down. Never mind, it was upside down. So, it says, travel to the land of the pharaohs of old and make your way to the banks of the Nile River. What? What does that mean? The pharaohs of old? The only old people I know are my parents. And I'm only in denial at home, so do I have to go home? Oh, no, wait, the Nile River. Oh, okay, not the Nile. Okay, over your heads? Okay. So, look, this is what it says. Don't be afraid. Come on. Look, right? Is that what it says? So, do you guys have any idea where we should go? Where? Okay, I think I heard 1, 2, 3. Egypt. Egypt? You think I should go to Egypt? You know, there are some stories in the Bible about Egypt. And I think you're right, Isaac. I think that's where we should go. So are you guys ready to learn about what happened in Egypt? All right, let's go. I'm going to go get some fish, some sushi, and then we'll see what's happening.
Joseph's family lived in Egypt. The family grew bigger and bigger. All the people in the family were called Israelites because they came from the family of Israel. Joseph had died and a new king took over Egypt. The new king did not like the Israelites, so he was afraid because there were so many of them. The king made the Israelites work very hard, but the harder the Israelites worked, the bigger their families grew. kill all their baby boys, the king said. But the nurses who helped the Israelite mommies and babies did not do what the king said. Now the king was very angry. Throw all their baby boys into the Nile River, he said. Around this time, a woman had a baby boy. She wanted him to live, so she hid him. When the baby was bigger, she put him in a basket and set the basket at the edge of the Nile River. The baby's older sister, Miriam, stayed nearby to watch the basket. Soon, the princess of Egypt went to the river to take a bath. She found the basket, and she felt sorry for the baby. The princess wanted the baby to be her son. Miriam asked the princess if she wanted to hire a woman to take care of the baby. The princess agreed, so Miriam brought her mother to care for him. The princess named the baby Moses. When Moses grew up, Moses found a job taking care of sheep. Back in Egypt, the new king still made the Israelite people work very hard. They cried out to God for help. God heard them, and he planned to send Moses to help them. One day, Moses saw a burning bush that was not burning up. Suddenly, God called from the bush, "Moses, Moses." "Here I am," Moses said. God told Moses to take off his sandals. Then God said, "My people are suffering. I want you to lead them out of Egypt to a good land I have for them." "What if they ask for your name? What should I tell them?" Moses asked. God said, "I am who I am. Tell them, I am has sent me to you." Then God warned that Moses' job would not be easy. The king in Egypt would say no, but God promised that the king would one day let God's people go. Moses made excuses and said, "I am not good at speaking. Please, send someone else." God was angry with Moses, but he agreed to send Moses' brother Aaron with him. God saved Moses' life so Moses could one day save God's people from the Egyptian king. God used his son, Jesus, to save people in an even better way. God sent Jesus to earth to save us from our sin.
Wow, great job helping Miles. I don't know if he ever said his name, but his name is Miles from the Great, is it the Great Race or the Great Chase? The Great Race. So good job. I can't wait for next week to see where he's going to be at. All right. So the new Pharaoh did not remember the great things that God told Joseph, right? All right. So Pharaoh did not like what was happening with the Israelites. And who are the Israelites? Who are they from? From Israel. Correct. Judah. Asher, sorry, the other bell. So he was afraid that the Israelites, because there were so many of them, that he made them into slaves. He was afraid that they would take over. So he made them work very, very hard. But the Israelites' families kept growing and growing. Do you have a big family? Yeah. It just seems like everyone seems to have another baby. You're like, what? Another sister? What? Another brother? Can we stop? Can we take a break? Right? But we kept growing. So Pharaoh ordered all the Israelites' baby boys to be killed. Isn't that crazy? Yeah, so the first boy was murdered by the Pharaoh. So Pharaoh was afraid that these babies would become men who would rise up against him, that they would fight and he wouldn't be in power anymore, because Pharaoh wanted to be the ruler of the world. But who's the ruler of the world? God, yeah, exactly. So that was Pharaoh's plan, but what is God's plan? And what is God's plan is actually the
question.
What is God's plan? Does anybody know? To free the Israelites. Close. Good chance. Do you happen to know anything else, Joseph? No? Ruthie? Did you read my lesson before I got up here? No. That was super, super, super duper close. So the answer is God's plan is to rescue his people, which is the whole world, from captivity, which you were there. So can we read the answer together? What is God's plan? God's plan is to rescue his people from captivity, right? Which he did. And he used Moses, which saw the what? What did he see? The burning bush. And that told him what? What was the burning bush? Was it his imagination? God. And he told him that he was going to use him. So, with that being said, with our new big picture question, we have a new memory verse. It's so small. So, you guys ready to read it? To memorize it? Twyla, are you ready? Elsie, are you ready? Ruthie, are you ready? Abigail, you ready? Asher's ready? So now, let's read it together. Remember, we have to be in sync. Bye, bye, bye. Right? Oh, you're too young for that? Are you ready? Now, one, two, three. Now, Moses was faithful in all God's house as a servant, but Christ is faithful over God's house as a son. And we are his house if indeed we hold fast our confidence and our boasting in our hope. Hebrews 3:5-6. Wow. That was pretty good. I am proud of you guys. So we won't go on for another hour. We'll cut it short right now. All right. Are you guys ready? Are you ready for chapel? Let's start it again. You guys ready? All right, let's start again. Good morning, Destiny kids. Oh, you guys are done? Okay.
Are you ready
to go home? Oh, okay. Man. That's as loud as you guys have been. That's not cool. All right. Well, thank you guys for being here. And we're going to close out with one more song. So get on up. One more song. We're going to sing along to one more song. Two more songs? All right, so our next song, which God always does, is Rescue Me. So let's sing along to our song.
So far, but here I am. How did I stray so far off course? How can I get back to the shore? Lord, here I am, and the waves are crashing all around.
That was very sweet song. Very sweet song. Well, thank you guys for being in chapel today. I can't wait to see you guys next week. I'm a dork. What'd you say? Oh. So thank you guys for being here today. Can't wait to see you guys next week. Can't wait to see where Miles is at next week. You guys have a great day. The little ones line up for Miss Ari. We'll see you next week. See you next week in chapel. You're in denial that I am Miles.
Fire is bad.
Oh, fire good?